Since you are interested in model railroad electronics, you probably have heard about the DCC++X project. The goal of the project is to take a simple Arduino Uno board, add a power circuit to it, and use it to run model trains via DCC. In this video, I am going to show you how to make DCC++X a full-blown LocoNet command station so you can connect your existing LocoNet devices. Welcome to the IoTT channel, I am Hans Tanner. If you just want to see how to set it up and run the trains, watch the next few minutes. If you are interested in the technical background and where this project is going, stay on for the second part of the video. The first thing we need is a working DCC++X system. I built mine using an Arduino Uno board and an IBT2 H-bridge driver. You can also use a power shield instead, which incorporates two H-bridges using the bipolar L268 driver, so you can use one for a programming track. You then load the Arduino with the command station code from the DCC++X webpage. Configure it for the correct H-bridge driver pins, and your system should be up and running. If you need help with that, there are plenty of resources available on YouTube and Facebook, as DCC++X has gained in popularity over the last 2 years or so. The IBT2 is powered from a DC power source. In this case, I am using a standard DC power supply that can output about 10 amps. The IBT2 can theoretically handle up to about 50 amps, but since this is going to be a DCC command station and not a welding machine, it is a good idea to limit the maximum current to about 5 or 10 amps using the DCC++X current limit settings. The second element needed is an IoTT stick with a LocoNet interface. The interface is connected to the IoTT stick, and in addition, we connect a 12-volt DC source to it in order to make it work as LocoNet master. Now we connect the hat side of the IoTT stick to the Arduino board. Ground goes to ground, pin 26 goes to Arduino pin 1, and pin 36 goes to Arduino pin 2. In the IoTT stick configuration screen, we select LocoNet as command source and Red Hat++ as the connected hat. Of course, you need to use the latest IoTT stick software from the GitHub page to support this feature. That's it if you are running your LocoNet throttles with a battery installed. Otherwise, we also need a LocoNet panel in order to power the connected LocoNet devices. We connect the backside of the panel to the track output and connect LocoNet to it. Now we can connect a throttle to LocoNet and it works just like any other LocoNet command station. We can assign a locomotive, control speed and functions, add and remove locomotives from consists, etc. Everything you expect to do with a command station. Furthermore, we can send switch commands to operate turnouts, and using other control devices like for example a yellow hat or JMRI on a computer, we can also send signal commands. That's it for the quick demonstration. If you like what you see, it might be a good idea to subscribe to the IoTT channel and hit the bell icon so that you are in a premium seat when I publish more videos on this topic. Now, let's talk a little bit about how it works and what is next in this project. If you want to set up a digital model railroad control system, you need 4 functional modules to make it work. First, a device providing a user interface so that you can enter commands and possibly read information from the model railroad system. Such a control device is, for example, a handheld throttle, but it could also be a cell phone app or a simple speed control knob on the central unit along with a simple display. The second module is the management system for your locomotives. In the simplest case, this is sort of a database that keeps track of the loco address and the current operating status like speed, functions, etc. A little more complex implementations also have functions to support consists of several locomotives using one single address. And to make it work, there must be a data interface between the user interface module and the locomotive management module so that user input can be received and feedback be provided. The third element is a DCC command generator that can translate locomotive and auxiliary device statuses into valid DCC commands. To comply with DCC standards, such a command generator needs to continuously send out locomotive refresh commands and be able to send single instances of switch and signal commands as requested by the user. The reason for the refresh commands is that the electrical contact of the rail-to-wheel system is unreliable and locomotives can lose contact once in a while. Therefore, the locomotive commands are repeated frequently to allow a locomotive to quickly reinitialize after a loss of signal. Stationary decoders, on the other hand, are wired more permanently. Therefore, commands are only sent if, for example, the position of a turnout is changing. And the fourth element is an amplifier or booster that amplifies the DCC signals to a voltage and amperage level that makes it possible to run locomotives and other devices on it. In most commercial systems, modules 2, 3 and 4 are combined in the so-called command station, and some command stations actually combine all four modules into the same device by adding a throttle knob. And while all four modules are mandatory for a working DCC system, there is no technical reason why they must be integrated into the same housing. This is more done for reasons of convenience, so that the user has a complete system in one single box. So, I built my system the modular way, using already existing components with just some minor modifications. Let's have a look at the individual modules. If you have been a viewer of the IoTT channel for a while, you have seen that the IoTT stick over time evolved into a real Loconet device capable of sending and receiving all kinds of Loconet messages. When combined with a suitable head, it can illuminate signals, set turnouts, or report button and block detector statuses. The only thing I never implemented in the stick is the management of locomotive addresses, even though I have kept a copy of the slot data in the stick memory for quite a while. So, to add command station functionality, I just had to add code for messages that manipulate locomotive addresses and deal with loco speed, functions and consists. That was not complicated and added only a few dozen lines of code. The more demanding task was generating the DCC signal because it requires a continuous rectangular pulse with relatively tight timing tolerances. So I was looking for a possibility to run that task in a separate module and finally decided to use the DCC++X software as signal generator. DCC++X runs on an Arduino board and provides a reliable DCC signal. As required, it features a refreshed port for locomotive commands and a single shot possibility for switch commands. It does not support DCC signal commands, but it has the possibility to send a sequence of DCC data bytes, so a signal command can be generated on the IoTT stick and then be sent out as DCC data bytes. So, all I needed. To communicate with the stick, it offers a serial interface with a simple text-based protocol, so sending locomotive, turnout and signal commands from the stick is really easy. To connect it to the head connector of the IoTT stick, all that is needed are transmit and receive signals and ground. Furthermore, I like the way the code of DCC++X is written. It is easy to understand and not complicated to modify if needed. To connect the DCC++ export to an amplifier, there are several options. The simplest is to use an Arduino PowerShield with an onboard L268H bridge driver. I prefer using MOSFET technology for high current applications, so I opted for using an IBT2 for the output. This module is cheap and can handle a lot of current. And the DCC++X software can easily be configured for it by setting the correct output pins. For the moment, I only connected the main track and left the programming track unconnected. And with that, my modular LoCoNet command station is working. I can connect one or several LoCoNet throttles, assign a locomotive, and start running the trains. And since it is using LoCoNet, I can connect all kind of other LoCoNet devices like switch decoders, feedback modules, or a computer. And of course, I have still all LoCoNet options available that the stick offers, like the MQTT gateway, an LB server to connect JMRI, and so on. So by combining the stick with DCC++X, it becomes a fully functional LoCoNet command station. Or maybe the other way around, by connecting DCC++X with the stick, the Arduino-based signal generator can now be controlled with LoCoNet devices. Quite cool, I think. Now for the obvious question, where is this project going? Well, here is my thinking right now, but as always, I am open for suggestions. Just use the comment section below to let me know. I already have the Yellow Hat board, which is using the 328P microcontroller, so it essentially is an Arduino board. Besides the controller, it has 32 input pins that can be used to connect buttons or occupancy sensors. And it has an LED chain connector for NeoPixel LEDs. The idea right now is to modify this board and make it a Red Hat++. The same basic layout with the stick in the middle and 32 input pins as before. On the right side, I am going to add one or two connectors for IBT2 booster modules. And on the board itself, I am going to add a dual-channel MOSFET H-bridge to power the programming track and the DCC wires of LoCoNet. If I make the board a little longer, I will also be able to integrate the LoCoNet interface with two or three RJ12 sockets. With that implemented, the Red Hat++ would be a LoCoNet command station with two track outputs configurable for 5 or 8 amps DCC track power, a programming track, an LED chain with a limited number of fully programmable LEDs, and two or three onboard LoCoNet outlets. On the software side, I would run DCC++X on the 328P, but in a modified version so that it can read the input pins and drive the LED chain. That would also require a slight extension of the existing interface protocol to control the LEDs. But all in all, the modifications are very limited. The functionality of the stick remains the same. The embedded logic modules like the event handler remain fully functional, and also all the LoCoNet and Wi-Fi based connection options like MQTT gateway and LB server can be used as before. That's what I have in mind right now. Please let me know what you think or what additional features you would like to see. And that's it for today. I hope this information was useful or at least interesting for you. And maybe you are even a little bit excited about the new possibilities that result from combining the IoT stick with DCC++X. If so, please click the like button below and leave a comment in the comment section to let me know. And if you want to experiment with that setup for yourself, you can download the latest version of the IoT stick software from the GitHub page, load it into your IoT stick, connect an Arduino with DCC++X to it and start playing with your trains. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.